On this week's show, Jeff Johnston gives us a quick look at the new Jayco Hummingbird travel trailer. Also, not all portable holding tanks are created equal, and Andy Bialorucki from Thetford shows Jeff the new sophisticated Smart Tote 2 LX portable holding tank and what makes it so different. And with summer here, Evanne shows us her take on homemade, or should I say RV-made, ice cream sandwiches. These stories and more on this week's Rollin On TV. Closed and Spanish captioning, where available, is sponsored by Jayco. At Jayco, we've been making family dreams come true since 1968.
Jayco has just added the new Hummingbird ultralight trailer line to its product lineup. There are three different floor plans available in the Hummingbird. All of them weigh less than 3,000 pounds, and of course that's dry and unloaded. By the time you add water and cargo, it's going to bump it up a little bit. But these can be towed by an awful lot of lightweight vehicles, like SUVs, minivans, and small pickups, and so on. The Hummingbird features all laminated construction. The floor, ceiling, and sidewalls are all vacuum bonded laminated. There is an optional insulation package available for the underbelly, which helps to give you a little bit more four seasons usability. And it comes with an awful lot of really nice features. For example, the power awning.
An awning is right up there as our number one priority RV accessory. And having an electric model makes campground setup that much easier.
There's a product called the Sway Command Package, which is something that's an automatic anti-sway feature that can be built into the trailer. And equally important, and something that the industry has needed for a long time, it's a key to like feature. You use one key for both locks on the door and the locks on the compartments, which makes it tremendously easy. You don't have that big bundle dangling around all the time. Another significant exterior feature is the electric tongue jack. People find that tremendously convenient. And when you go inside, there's a lot more livability inside than you might expect. So let's take a look. It can be amazing how much space the Jayco designers can pack into a tiny little trailer like this. Now, you're not going to be able to hold a square dance in here, but it has everything you need for comfortable camping and living. But you can bring some of your square dance friends in to sit at the front U-shaped dinette here, where you have room for probably about six people seated around here. And the dinette table, of course, breaks down, and you can turn this into another sleeping area if you have guests or you have some kids you want to accommodate. The kitchen includes compact refrigerator, microwave convection oven, which is extremely handy, of course, for that morning coffee or anytime you need something a little quicker than you can make out on the campfire. This kitchen, because the kitchen unit is in the slide out, we have a huge depth here. So you don't have a lot of width for working space, but there's all kinds of extra room behind here. Conventional two burner stove, nice size sink that's large enough that you can actually get your hands under it and do something in it, cleaning dishes and so on, or food prep. There's an adequate amount of storage throughout here for a small trailer like this. Back here by the entrance, we have the AM, FM, Bluetooth, just about everything stereo, and all of the unit's controls and monitor functions are clustered into one place, which makes it pretty convenient to keep an eye on things. And back here, there's a nice Furrion TV, which you can swing out and adjust to be able to see it comfortably from the dinette area. Plus, tucked away here, there's a 2x4 foot portable table, something that we always seem to need more of is space out in the campsite. So even if you have a picnic table out there, it's kind of nice to have this portable table to set up right next to the trailer so you can stash your coats on it when you're coming in, put food on it, or your recreational items. The bathroom is a self-contained unit. It's a wet bath, which is kind of one of the compromises that you put up with in a smaller trailer like this. However, the wet bath does have a decent sized little sink in the corner. The toilet has plenty of knee and leg room, and knee and leg room is important in that area. There's a vent fan, of course, and the LED light, so you have plenty of illumination for whatever's going on in there. The main bed area covers the front of the trailer. It has a Simmons mattress, which is really comfortable, and it goes wall to wall in the trailer, which is a little under 7 feet, so you have lots of space for even a tall camper, which is neat. and there are small mesh enclosed storage pockets on the walls for the little necessities that you're going to have with you when you're near the bed, reading glasses, books, and so on. The Jayco Hummingbird trailer is an interesting addition to the lightweight product line. With its aerodynamic shape, it should offer easy towing, and you have three different floor plans available. This is the 17FD or front dinette. It's compact, but it provides all the livability somebody could want in a small trailer. It's certainly worth taking a look.
For more information about the Jayco Hummingbird trailer, log on to our website at rollinontv.com.
Coming up after the break, we'll see how to make an unpopular RVing chore a lot more pleasant.
Thetford's tough, new Titan sewer hose is virtually uncrushable. Ever had your sewer hose run over by an RV? Watch Titan bounce back. Titan hose is made of Thetford's proprietary blend of TPE and provides the highest degree of puncture and abrasion resistance. It has an easy-to-grip fitting for a leak-free connection to RV outlets. A rotating elbow easily aligns and allows a convenient connection and straighter flow. Titan provides more for your money and is another innovation from Thetford, the RV sanitation leader.
When you have a Truma AquaGo instant hot water system, you can expect to make a lot of new friends.
Hi, I'm Jeff with Rollin On TV. We're here at the campground with Andy from Thetford. And Andy, last night we had a really great time with the chili cook-off and the draft beer tasting festival. But obviously that's going to put a real stress on the system on here in the trailer. So it's a good thing we're here to talk about your new Smart Tote 2. Portable holding tanks have been part of the RV industry for decades, but you guys have come up with some pretty sophisticated new features from what I understand.
You're correct. Portable waste tanks have been around for a while, and for those that don't know, they're used when you're at a campsite and there may not be a dump station nearby. So as you fill up your holding tanks, rather than breaking camp to take your RV to the dump station, you can fill into the portable waste tank and then take your portable waste tank to the dump station. And Thetford, as the sanitation expert, we've really taken a close look at what is needed by the RVers. We want to make it the most convenient process for the RVers. We recognize that this may not be the most fun thing to do, but we've designed it in such a way that it can be easy and can be very clean and sanitary.
Well, sophistication is something that the average RVer may not think about when in terms of a portable waste tank, but your new product sounds pretty interesting, so let's go take a look at it.
Oh, great.
Oh, so this is it. Looks a lot different than the ones we're accustomed to.
Yes, so here we have our 27-gallon LX unit. LX stands for luxurious, if you will. And what it has is it's got a handle built in and some front wheels, which makes it a lot easier for towing. This is a 27-gallon, so it can be heavy, over 200 pounds. And a lot of people want to be able to use the handle and the wheels to tow it.
Yeah, and I notice there's a little cutout here that looks an awful lot like the diameter of a hitch ball.
That's right. So if you're not hand towing the unit, you can mount it to a ball hitch and tow it with a vehicle to the dump station.
Yeah, slowly, cautiously.
Correct.
Right?
It's not built for the Indy 500. You want to keep it within a 5 mile an hour speed, so.
Yeah. Well, it's nice to have it tall like that so I can stand up without having to bend over to work on it.
That's a good point, Jeff. One of the things that we did with this handle is we made it a telescoping handle. For a tall guy like you, it telescopes and you can extend it. Here it is extended and you can see it's very comfortable. I think you're comfortable, are you?
Yeah, oh yeah. Be able to stand up here without bending over.
Good.
That's cool.
Good. And for a guy that's a little bit shorter like me, if you don't want to telescope it, you can simply have it telescope down and I could tow it as well.
Yeah, very cool. So once we've got the unit filled, so to speak, and we're heading over for the station. It's nice current turning radius, easy maneuverable, and you can show off to your campground buddies how well you can back up. Okay, so we're at the spot. What comes next?
At Jayco, we're a lot more than just an RV manufacturer. We're all about family. And we've been making family dreams come true since 1968. To see our complete product line and find your nearest Jayco dealer, visit us online at jayco.com or just log on to rollinontv.com. At Norco, we realize that some of your favorite RV destinations are off the grid. And Norco refrigerators are uniquely designed with that RV experience in mind. We call it Freedom Unplugged. To learn more about our Norco RV refrigerator line or to find a dealer near you, visit our website at norco.com.
So, one of the things that's great about our Smart Tote 2 is that it's got a storage compartment. And inside this storage compartment, Jeff, is everything that you need to fill and empty your onboard holding
tank. So you don't have to haul a hose along with you through the campground or anything. That's great.
That's right. The thing that's nice about this is that the hose always stays connected. You never have to disconnect or reconnect a hose. You don't have to store a hose separately. Many of the other tanks on the market don't have a hose built on board like this. So everything that you need is all right here.
All right, we've got the Smart Tote 2 positioned next to the trailer where it's supposed to be. We're ready to go. What's next?
All right, so before you fill the Smart Tote 2, the first thing that you want to do is open this little compartment door. And underneath this door is a built-in level gauge. All Smart Tote 2 LX models come with a built-in level gauge. Now, what do you think is great about the level gauge?
Well, if I'm cooking a turkey, the red button pops up and says I'm ready. And I suppose that that gauge is calibrated for vegetarian on one end and paleo on the other, or something along those lines.
Kind of like that, Jeff. You're on the right track. So what happens is when you're filling the tank from the bottom, liquid rises and that stem pops up and the water will shut off, the stem will shut off flow.
Okay.
And it prevents a messy overfilling situation. Okay. So now that you have that compartment door open, you're ready to fill the tank.
Okay, so do you think a first timer can handle it?
I think you should give it a shot.
Okay, we'll see what happens here. All right, so step number one, of course, I saw earlier, open the compartment and take the vent off. And this just stretches out, okay. And once it's connected,
you simply open the valves and fill the tank. If there's any remaining liquid in here, you shut the valves, you press the stem down on the tank, and that will release any liquid that's remaining into the hose back into the tank.
Oh, okay, so yeah, so it knocks out the air pocket. And,
correct.
Okay. All right, and then?
Now you're ready to take it to the dump station.
And we're supposed to hold this up just to keep everything that's at the water level in the tank?
Exactly. Okay. Right. You're not a first timer, are you?
Well, I've had a couple of bowls of chili in my day, so. Okay, and then we just collapse this back down. That's an interesting sound it makes. Okay. Fold it up, and now we're ready for the walk.
Correct.
Great. All right, here we are. First things first, open the vent cap. And now, and let me know if I do something wrong here, because this is not a place where I want to make a mistake, okay?
I got you covered.
If I remember right, we open this up, stretch this guy out.
Take the cap off, keep the hose elevated.
Yep, because of the liquid level in there. And we'll pop the dump tube on here and then
put that nozzle in. Now that nozzle comes equipped with all LX models.
Oh, okay.
The 18, 27, and 35-gallon LX all include this sewer nozzle, which is a nice feature. You don't have to buy anything else.
Okay, and then we want to maintain that upside-down P-trap.
Correct.
Right? So put that down here, and then to dump it, there's no valves or anything. All we do is push down on the hose.
Yep, once you have your nozzle in the sewer, you push the hose down just like that. and wait for the holding tank to empty.
Okay, and if and we talked about the level a little bit, so if you said the tank is made to automatically dump with the bottom?
That's right. Everything inside the tank is meant to have a gravity feed so that all the liquid contents completely evacuate the tank. If you're on level ground, the tank will completely evacuate.
All right, and then once it's emptied, we once again raise it back up and rinse that off when we get back to the campsite. Put this on quickly,
correct?
I suppose. All right.
Simple
as that.
Collapse
that guy back down. Cover that up, and then for the sake of the neighbors, we'll seal that back up.
Great job. Perfect.
Okay, terrific.
So easy. Now, another feature that's built in is a clean-out port. And when you're done emptying the holding tank, you can simply open this little door, insert a garden hose, wash out the tank, rinse it nice and good, and then simply close the doors. The tanks come in several different sizes. Our two-wheel versions come in a 12-gallon, 18-gallon, 27-gallon, and 35-gallon. Our LX models, which we demonstrated here today, come in three sizes, an 18-gallon, a 27-gallon, and a 35-gallon.
And the two-wheel versions just have a handle and you more or less carry them like a luggage in an airport with wheels?
That's correct. It's a hand tow. We do offer an accessory tow strap that you can purchase separately. That is an option. We basically have a size and a price for any budget.
Well, it looks like a pretty darn handy thing to have if you spend a little bit of time in any one given campground.
They're very handy, and we sell a lot of them. So it's been a great product for us, and we look forward to helping people with this situation.
And it looks like with the improvements you've made, too, it makes it even easier to use.
That's right.
Well, I'd like to thank Andy from Thetford for helping us to learn a lot more about the Smart Tote 2.
Let's go, Jeff.
Okay. Oof. Dang. Must be all that rich living.
At Rollin On TV, we love working with our sponsors. And the one thing we love most is giving stuff away. In this case, the stuff is Thetford's new Smart Tote 2 LX portable holding tank. Now, we're not just giving away one, we're actually giving away eight of them, one each week for 8 weeks. In case you missed a story we did on this new sophisticated portable tank and how it works, you can watch the story on our website, or there's a video link right on the contest page. The Smart Tote 2 contest starts the week of July 24th, and to enter is simple. Go to our website at rollonontv.com, click on the link to the contest page where you'll find all the information about the contest and a simple entry form. Remember, we'll be drawing a winner each week for 8 weeks, and you only have to enter once. So, what are you waiting for? Next, Evanne whips up some killer ice cream sandwiches that are perfect for a summer treat. But first, a word from our sponsors. Never run out of propane again. With Level Check, there's no more guesswork. Just run the gauge over the tank, and when the light turns from red to green, you'll know exactly how much propane you have left. It's that simple. Level Check, another great product from Truma. For more information, visit levelcheck.com. For 50 years, Campers Inn RV has been your trusted resource for RV sales, service, and accessories. Now, with 15 locations along the East Coast from New Hampshire to Florida, we'll be giving you that same family-friendly service and be your trusted resource for another 50 years. For information and locations, visit us online at campersinn.com.
When I was a kid, my mom would take me to the store for a six-pack of ice cream sandwiches. Chocolate brownie on the outside, vanilla ice cream on the inside, and there was always a debate in my neighborhood. bite the sandwich or lick the edges and squeeze the outside until the soft, mushy ice cream was gone, and then eat the brownie cookie. Well, now that I'm a big kid, guess what? I still love ice cream sandwiches. But since I'm older and a little bit wiser, I've taken to glamming them up. So today we're making gelato sandwiches. Sure, these are great for a summer evening, but even more fun, an ice cream sandwich party. Gather up an assortment of cookies, a selection of ice cream, gelato, sorbet, or sherbet, a few topping-like goodies, and a fun-loving group of friends of all ages, and you have a make-your-own ice cream sandwich party. Perfect. It's really easy, so let's do it. So I've got three different kinds of cookies. I've got some delicious thin ginger snaps, I've got a white chocolate chunk macadamia nut cookie, and I've got a Milano cookie, and this is topped with some dark chocolate and some salted pretzel bits. Really delicious. For our gelato selection today, I've got a sea salt caramel, I've got a coffee chocolate chip, and I've got a Sicilian pistachio. Delicious. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with our ginger cookie. We're going to put our gelato on the back side of the cookie. This way we'll have a nice pretty top. Got some hot water here. Just help me scoop the frozen ice cream, which by the way, the gelato has been sitting out for just a little bit. It softens it, it makes it a little bit easier. Some nice scoop of gelato. Yes. Right on our cookie, like so. Another cookie, again, the gelato in the side, pretty part of the cookie up. And if we want to, we can put some delicious toppings on the edge. In this case, I think it'd be really great with some coconut. So we'll just put a little bit of coconut right on the edge like this. Yes. Nice. All right. Great. That's one. So let's do our white chocolate chunk macadamia nut. Again, I'm going to put the gelato on the back side of the cookie, and the coffee chocolate chip is what I think would be really great on this. So let's get some gelato. A nice gentle push, just a little bit of pressure, easy peasy. And I think perhaps the cacao nibs would be great on this. Yeah. Oh, there you have it. And that's what that looks like. Yum. All right. And the last one we're going to do is the Milano. And then we're going to put the pistachio gelato on. So we've got our beautiful little petite Milano. Going to reach in here, grab some of this pistachio. Right on it like this. Ooh, that might have been a little bit too much. That's all right. Is there such a thing as too much ice cream in your ice cream sandwich? Ooh, this looks like a keeper. And how about some almonds? A little bit of chopped almonds around the edge, just like that. And bam, you've got ice cream, or in our case, our glammed up gelato sandwiches. You can make these in advance, and if you do so, just wrap your ice cream sandwiches or your gelato or sorbet or sherbet sandwiches up in aluminum foil, pop them back into the freezer, let them harden up just a little bit. If you're actually having a party and people are going to eat them right after they make them, don't let your gelato or your ice cream soften too much, or it'll be hard to bite into and enjoy. This super fun, super sweet treat will bring out the kid in everyone. Go ahead, try it. I know you're gonna like it. RV Cooking Show, Evanne here. Hey, I'd like an invite. Cheers.
We hope you enjoyed this week's show. And for additional information on anything you saw on the show, along with additional videos and stories, visit our website at rollinontv.com. You can also follow us on Twitter and like us on Facebook. As usual, This has been another fun production. For the latest up-to-the-minute RV news, visit our media partners at rvbusiness.com.